Can you tell me, are the voice and screen clear once again? Yes, all okay now? I think there was some technical problem. Now everything sorted. Okay, good, fine. So guys, you were telling me the solution of question number 4. Tell me, distance is always ABCD. Shortest length between the two points, path covered by the object between the two points. Yes, all of you are giving the correct answer. Sir, the answer is path covered between the two points. It's path covered between the two points. Okay, it's not the product of length and time. Distance is not the product. Product means multiplication. Distance is not the multiplication of length and time. Okay, so correct answer is the path covered by the object between the two points. That's the distance. Okay, next, displacement is always positive, always negative, may be positive as well as negative, neither positive nor negative. Bola, tell me. Displacement is always positive, or it can be negative, maybe positive or negative. Everyone, perfect. Yani, correct answer. Very good. Sheetal, correct answer. Everyone try. Sir, displacement can be positive. Rightward displacement we can take positive. Leftward displacement we can take negative. So sir, displacement may be positive as well as negative. Displacement may be positive as well as negative. Okay, displacement can be positive as well as negative, because rightward displacement we take positive, leftward displacement we take negative. Okay, so it may be positive as well as negative. So this is going to be the correct option. Okay, next. Question number 6. Which of the following is not the characteristic of displacement? Yes, very good. Everyone, which of the following is not the characteristic of displacement? It is always positive. It has both magnitude and direction. Yes, displacement has both magnitude and direction. Yes, all of you are giving the correct answer. It can be zero. Yes, it can be zero. Displacement, start point, end point. If start point and end point both are same, then shortest distance will be what? Start point, end point both are same. So it has both magnitude and it has both magnitude and direction. Yes, it can be zero. Yes, its magnitude is less than or equal to actual path length, means displacement is less than or equal to actual path length. Displacement is less than or equal to distance. Yes, this is also true. But what is asked? Which of the following is not the characteristic of? Which of the following is not the characteristics of? Option B, C and D are the characteristics. Okay, so Radha, answer will be option A and not C. Now reply me in the chat box. Is this clear to all of you? Reply me small C. Yes, no. So here we have to select option number A. They have asked which of the following is not the characteristic. Option B, C and D are the characteristics of displacement. It has both magnitude and direction because it is a vector. It can be zero, start point, end point same. Its magnitude is always less than or equal to the actual path length. Yes, this is also possible. Why not? Next. Okay, everyone try now the question number 7. SI unit of displacement is, means standard unit of displacement is meter per second square. Let me zoom it. Now it will be clearly visible to all of you. What is that? Meter per second square. Or none of these, sir. Very simple. This was very simple question for us, sir. It is meter. Unit of displacement is meter. Standard unit of displacement is meter. Okay. In 5 minutes, distance between a pole and a car changes progressively. What is true about the car? Car is at rest. Car is in motion. Nothing can be said with this information and none of the above. What is given? There is one car. Okay. Here we have one car. Here we have one car. And this car is approaching. This car is approaching. Just a second. Let me draw a line like this. Or let me just annotate it. Let's say this car is approaching a pole. Okay, here we have one pole. Okay, and here we have a car. This car is approaching, or rather, instead of saying approaching or departing, what they have written, in the 5 minutes, distance between pole and the car changes progressively. Distance between pole and car is changing. So pole is not changing its position, so it must be at rest. So pole must be at rest. Okay, sir. But this distance between car and pole is changing. This distance between car and pole must be changing. So therefore, this car must be in motion. This car must be in motion. So according to this logic, we have to select the answer. So car is at rest? No. If the car is at rest, how can this distance change? No. It is already given that the distance between the car and the pole is changing. Distance between the car and the pole is changing. So definitely car cannot be at rest. So definitely the car is in motion. Okay. So option C and D are just given only to just trick us. Okay. Additional versus option C and D deun thevlay. But we are 100% sure that if the distance between this pole and the car is changing, certainly we know pole is fixed to the ground. Jo kay pole asto to tar ground la fix kelela asto, mhanje to pole tar rest la aahe. आणि तरी सुद्धा हे डिस्टन्स चेंज व्हायला लागले म्हणजे कार मस्ट बी इन मोशन. सो वी कॅन से कार इज इन मोशन. रिप्लाय मी इन द चॅट बॉक्स. क्लियर स्मॉल सी एव्हरीवन. व्हेरी गुड. येस. सो दिस डिस्कशन्स विल इम्प्रूव्ह युअर थिंकिंग ॲबिलिटीज. ओके. येस सर. नेक्स्ट. Next. All right. Next question is question number 9. Distance. Always positive, always negative, maybe positive or negative. Neither positive nor negative. Fast. A, B, C, D. No need to write the option. Just tell me A, B, C, D. Yes. Sir, distance is just a path length. It is always positive. Distance is just the path length. So it is always positive. Distance cannot be negative, it's path length. Okay, so maybe positive, maybe negative, do not select this answer. Okay, distance is just a path length, so it is always positive. Displacement can be positive or negative, but distance is always positive. Okay, next. Question number 10. Motion is the change of what? Motion is change of mass. Motion is change of position. Motion is change of time. Or motion is change of shape of object. Yes, 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 yes. All of you are giving the correct answer. Sir, motion is a change of position. The very first definition in this chapter was motion is what? Change in position is called as motion. Change in position is called as motion. Okay. Next. 11. Vector quantities are those which have vector quantities are those which have, bola, correct, correct, yes everyone, huh, expecting some more replies, bola balanu, vector quantities are those which have only direction, only magnitude, both magnitude and direction, none of these, huh? Yes, all of you have given the correct answer, sir. Vector quantities are those which have both magnitude and direction, which have both magnitude and direction. Okay, just give me one second. Wait for a second. All right. Just give me a second. All right. Next, what is true about scalar quantities? What is true about scalar quantities? Huh? A, B, C, D. Read the questions, read the option, and tell me the correct one. Bola balanu. What is true about scalar quantities? Question number 12. Scalars have directions also. Scalars can be added arithmetically, means simple addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. That is called as arithmetics. Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Simple wali addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. There are special laws for scalar addition. Scalars have special method to represent. No. Vectors have special method to represent. Vectors have special laws for their addition. Okay. हे सगळ्या ह्या सगळ्या ज्या काय प्रॉपर्टीज आहेत बघा ह्या सगळ्या वेक्टरचे आहेत. वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज हॅव डायरेक्शन्स. वेक्टर्स हॅव स्पेशल लॉज ऑफ ऍडिशन. ओके, ह्या सगळ्या प्रॉपर्टीज ह्या स्केल, ही स्केलरची प्रॉपर्टी नाही आहे, ही पण स्केलरची प्रॉपर्टी नाही आहे, ही पण स्केलरची प्रॉपर्टी नाही आहे. वेक्टर क्वांटिटीज हॅव डायरेक्शन्स. देर आर स्पेशल लॉज फॉर वेक्टर ऍडिशन. अँड वेक्टर्स हॅव स्पेशल मेथड टू रिप्रेझेंट. ओके, and vectors have special method to represent, which is true about scalar. Scalar baddal kay true ahe? Scalars can be added arithmetically. Yes, 5 kg plus 7 kg, 5 kg minus 7 kg, 7 kg minus 2 kg. Mass is scalar and it can be very easily added. Okay, very easily in the sense arithmetically. Simple addition, subtraction, multiplication, division is called as arithmetics. No separate care is required. Okay, but for the vector addition and subtraction, you have to take care of direction also. For vector addition and subtraction, vectors have directions, so you have to take care of directions also. So vectors cannot be easily added. There are separate and special laws for the vector addition. Okay sir, so scalars can be easily added. Easily added means just added arithmetically. Up to this point, reply me in the chat box, clear? Bola balanu, samajhla ka? Small c. Just give me a second. Is this discussion clear? What is true about scalar quantities? Samajhla? Good. Next, next is what is true of, sorry, next is example of vector quantities are, tell me which of the following are the examples. Option A, B, C, D. Fast everyone. Examples of vector quantities are, velocity is a vector, length is a scalar, mass is a scalar. Speed is a scalar, length is a scalar, mass is also scalar. Time is scalar, displacement vector, mass is scalar. Velocity is vector, displacement is vector, force is vector. So examples of vector quantities are, sir, option number D. All of you gave the correct answer. Very good. All of you gave the correct answer. Next, question number 14. Which of the following is not a vector? Which of the following is not a vector? Velocity is a vector. Acceleration is a vector. Weight is ultimately force. Okay. So if weight is ultimately force, it must be a vector. Okay, because ultimately weight is a force. Okay. So speed is scalar. This we already know. Velocity is a vector. This we already know. Acceleration is also the vector. This we already know. But weight is actually the gravitational force. Okay. Force because of the earth. Okay. So ultimately it is force. And we know force is a vector. So weight is a vector quantity. Mass is scalar. Mass is scalar, but weight is vector. Okay, because weight is actually force. So here, which option we have to select? Which of the following is not a vector? Not a vector means scalar. So here we have to select speed. Here we have to select option A. Okay. Next. Question number 15. Time is an example of. ABCD. Yes, this was, I think this question was asked by some student itself. तुमच्यापैकीच कुणीतरी बाळांनो हा क्वेश्चन मला विचारला होता. सर, टाइम स्केलर आहे की वेक्टर आहे? At that time, I told you about this. Sir, time is, yes, all of you are giving the correct answer. Very good. Sir, time is scalar. Don't say time flows always in one direction. Okay, that's not the direction we are talking about. When we say direction, we are basically talking about east, west, north, south, up, down. These are the directions which we are talking about. Time asa asto ka? Time of 15 seconds in north direction? No. Time of 17 seconds in the upward direction? No. Time has no sense of direction. Time always goes on increasing, that we know, but it has no sense of direction. So it should be termed as a scalar quantity. Okay, it should be termed as a scalar quantity. Okay, so tell me, are these answers given to all the 15 questions as a DPP clear to all of you? Bola balanno, he sagle answers balanno clear zale? Yes, very good. Yes. Okay, how much time we have in our lecture now? It's 11:48. Okay, yes, we have a time of 20 to 25 minutes still. Okay, so we will continue with our theory. Okay, and note that physics lecture time is 11:15 now. Okay, sawa akra, 11:15. Not 11:50, 11:15. Okay, fine. Next. So what was the last point that you wrote in the notebook? Can you tell me? What was the last point that you wrote in the notebook? I think we were discussing various types of speeds: average speed, uniform speed, variable speed, instantaneous speed. Okay, these are the types of the speeds that we have discussed in yesterday's lecture. Okay, now in today's lecture we will discuss the further types of speed. Not further types of speed. All the types of speed we have already covered. So today we will cover the types of velocities. Okay, so write down everyone along with me. Can you see the whiteboard? Yes. Okay, now I have shared the whiteboard here. You can see that. Chalo, everyone write down along with me. Liha balando majha barobar. First is velocity. Velocity is what? Velocity is defined as displacement upon time. Velocity is defined as displacement upon time. Displacement upon time. Okay, this is also called as average velocity. This is also called as average velocity. Total displacement upon total time. This is actually called as average velocity. So first type of velocity is average velocity. You can simply write it as total displacement upon total time. Total displacement divided by. Aryan is asking, sir, what about homework? Aryan, you join right now. Aryan, atta join zhalas ka? Yes. Homework solve zhala ba? Homework sagla solve kela apan. You just see the recording of this lecture, okay? You should have joined on time, okay? Time is 11:15. Okay, so total displacement upon total time. Total displacement upon total time is called as average velocity. This is the first type of velocity that you have to remember. Okay, sir. Next is uniform velocity. Okay, when to say velocity as uniform? When to say velocity as uniform? So write down uniform. Uniform velocity. Write down uniform velocity. Now, when to say velocity as uniform? Sir, velocity is a vector. When to say vector as uniform or when to say vector as a constant? Sir, vector can be said to be constant only if its direction is not changing. Also, its magnitude is not changing. In that situation, we can say velocity is uniform or vector is constant. Okay, any vector is uniform or any vector is constant means its direction as well as magnitude is not changing. So write down when direction and magnitude of velocity are not changing with time. Time nusar magnitude and direction are not changing. In that case, you will say velocity is uniform. We say velocity is uniform. We say velocity is uniform. Okay. We say velocity is uniform. Very simple example. Direction should not change and magnitude also should not change. Okay, sir. So let's say we have one car. Let's say we have one car here. Okay. When the car is at this location, its velocity is rightward. 10 meter per second. When the car is here, again its velocity is rightward, 10 meter per second. Direction should not change, magnitude should not change. When the same car is here, okay, when the same car is here, it has same magnitude of velocity, 10 meter per second. Direction rightward. So direction should not change as well as magnitude should not change. Okay, in that situation only you can say velocity is uniform. Uniform means constant. When to say vector as a constant? its magnitude is not changing, its direction is not changing. Reply in the chat box, clear and written, CW. Bola bolan. Good, very good. Yes. Chalo. Next type of velocity. On the next page. Non-uniform velocity. Very simple. Non-uniform velocity. Non-uniform velocity. Sir, this is very simple point. When velocity is changing with time, okay, we say non-uniform velocity. We say non-uniform velocity. Now when to say velocity has changed? If magnitude or both magnitude and direction, और बोथ मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन, एक तर मैग्नीट्यूड चेंज हो दे, नहीं तर डायरेक्शन चेंज हो दे, नहीं तर बोथ चेंज हो दे. इफ मैग्नीट्यूड और डायरेक्शन और बोथ मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन चेंज, इन दैट केस वी से वेलोसिटी चेंज्ड. In that case, we say velocity changed. And velocity changed and the motion non-uniform. This type we already know. Write down up to this, understand it, and then reply me in the chat box, clear and written. Good. Everyone reply me. Non-uniform velocity. Next type of velocity was non-uniform velocity. Good. Done. Written. Even zala. Yes. Okay. Next type of velocity is very simple. Just like instantaneous speed, you have the next type of velocity as instantaneous velocity. Write down. Instantaneous velocity. Write down. Velocity. At a particular instance of time, ya moment la velocity kiti hai? What is the velocity at a particular moment of time? Okay, velocity at a particular instance of time is called instantaneous velocity. Okay, for example, let's say the particle is moving from point A to B. This is point A, this is point B. At some particular time, the particle is here. Okay, at some particular time, the particle is here. What is the velocity of the particle? What is the velocity of the body when it is here? We do not want velocity for the entire journey A to B. No. we do not want velocity of entire journey A to B, because that is average velocity. A to B complete motion chi velocity jeva tumhi kadal, complete journey chi velocity jeva tumhi kadal, so that will give you average velocity. No, you don't want that. So in that situation, what you will do, you will bring these points A and B very 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 close to the given point. You will bring the points A and B very 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 close to the given point. Now there you will be having very very small displacement. There you will be having very very small displacement ds, and that will take very 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 small time to move between the two points. Okay, so yaad, A pasun B paryant jayala lagnara time ani A pasun B paryant halli displacement very very small, so that is called as instantaneous velocity. Very very small displacement divided by very very small time required, and displacement is a vector, velocity is a vector. Now reply me in the chat box, is this clear to all of you? Just like instantaneous speed, this is instantaneous velocity. Everyone clear and written? Bola bolan. At given instance of time, atta kiti velocity te paije, not for the entire journey, not the average, right now what is the velocity? Good, very good. Clear and written. CW. Yes. Chalo, next. What is next? See, there is one statement, one note is written. Let us write that note. Write down. Magnitude of instantaneous velocity. Yes, velocity is a vector. Instantaneous velocity is also the vector. Its magnitude we have to take. Okay, magnitude of instantaneous velocity is equal to instantaneous speed. Kya moment ka speed is equal to instantaneous speed. Karan balano speed ka asnar hai, instantaneous speed ka asnar hai. Very 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 small distance divided by very 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 small time. Mala sanga ki very very small distance ds hai, very very small displacement ds bar hai. Mhanje yacha magnitude jar ghetla, direction visrun ja. Okay, if you forget about direction, then what you get is the instantaneous speed. This was actually the definition of instantaneous speed, and this is the definition of instantaneous velocity. So if you forget about the directions, magnitude of instantaneous velocity is actually instantaneous speed. Magnitude of instantaneous velocity is equal to instantaneous speed. Velocity kay asnar hai, displacement upon time, and instantaneous speed kay asnar hai, distance upon time. But sir, here distance and displacement both are same, a very very small straight line path, and for this straight line path we all know distance equal to displacement. For a very very small straight line path, displacement and distance both are same, so therefore people say magnitude of displacement equal to magnitude of distance. Dt la dt same hai, ds la ds same hai, मग इन्स्टंटेनियस वेलॉसिटी आणि इन्स्टंटेनियस स्पीड सेम असणार. फक्त काय करावं लागेल, इन्स्टंटेनियस वेलॉसिटीचं वळणं डायरेक्शन विसरून जा, मॅग्निट्यूड घ्या. ओके, सो मॅग्निट्यूड ऑफ इन्स्टंटेनियस वेलॉसिटी इज कॉल्ड ॲज इन्स्टंटेनियस स्पीड ऑर इज इक्वल टू इन्स्टंटेनियस स्पीड. बोला बळांनो, हे डिस्कशन क्लिअर झालं का? इज दिस डिस्कशन क्लिअर टू ऑल ऑफ यू? येस नो? Yes. All right. Next. So now we have covered all the points of all the types of speed and all the types of velocities. Okay, all the types of speeds and all the types of velocities. Now let us today try to solve some questions again. Okay, आता बढ़ानो अनहिंग का ही questions solve कराएँ सब प्रयत्न करो यार. Okay. Now the question is like this. Question is like this. When the average speed, when the average speed and average velocity or let me write it like this, when the average speed and magnitude of average velocity and magnitude of average velocity, just keep on writing along with me, when the average speed and magnitude of average velocity are equal, कुठल्या केस मध्ये एवरेज स्पीड आणि एवरेज वेलॉसिटी चा मॅग्निट्यूड इक्वल असेल. सोल्युशन, ट्राय टू अंडरस्टँड, व्हॉट इज द व्हॅल्यू ऑफ एवरेज स्पीड? एवरेज स्पीड इज डिस्टन्स अपॉन टाइम. ओके सर, अँड व्हॉट इज द एवरेज वेलॉसिटी? What is the average velocity? Sir, it is displacement upon time. Okay, we are considering the magnitude. Okay, direction part of it forget about direction part of it. These two straight line means magnitude. Time tar scalar astoy, टाइम तर बाळांनो स्केलरच असतोय, त्यामुळे त्याला काय मॅग्निट्यूड परत लिहायची गरज नाही. टाइमला परत नुसता मॅग्निट्यूडच असतोय. ओके, टाइम स्केलरच आहे, परत त्याचा सेपरेटली मॅग्निट्यूड काढायची काय गरज नाही. हा, डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज अ वेक्टर अँड इट्स मॅग्निट्यूड इज टू बी कन्सिडर्ड. सो दीज टू स्ट्रेट लाईन मीन्स मॅग्निट्यूड. ओके, सो ऍव्हरेज स्पीडचा फॉर्म्युला काय झाला? डिस्टन्स अपॉन टाइम. व्हॉट इज द फॉर्म्युला ऑफ ऍव्हरेज स्पीड? सर, डिस्टन्स अपॉन टाइम. ओके, व्हॉट इज द फॉर्म्युला ऑफ magnitude of? कसं वाचायचं याला? How to read this? Magnitude of average velocity. Here we have average speed equal to distance upon time. Here we have average velocity equal to magnitude of displacement upon time. आता मला सांगा, average speed आणि average velocity जर equal पाहिजे असतील, write down. Now for average speed equal to magnitude of average velocity, ही कंडिशन जर बाळांनो सॅटिस्फाय व्हायची असेल, लेफ्ट हँड साइड जर इक्वल पाहिजे असतील, इफ यू वॉन्ट दीज लेफ्ट हँड साइड इक्वल, दीज राईट हँड साइड मस्ट बी इक्वल. ओके, डिस्टन्स अपॉन टाइम मस्ट बी इक्वल टू मॅग्निट्यूड ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट अपॉन टाइम. ओके सर, टाइम कॅन्सल. येस, टाइम कॅन्सल, देन डिस्टन्स मस्ट बी इक्वल टू मॅग्निट्यूड ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट. आता मला सांगा बाळांनो, डिस्टन्स इक्वल टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट पाहिजे असेल, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सॅटिस्फाय दिस कंडिशन, डिस्टन्स इक्वल टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट, टेल मी व्हेन दिस इज पॉसिबल. कधी आहे पॉसिबल तेच विचारले ना, व्हेन. व्हेन इट विल बी पॉसिबल टू गेट डिस्टन्स इक्वल टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट? टेक युअर टाइम, थिंक ओवर इट अँड रिप्लाय मी इन द चॅट बॉक्स. आय एम वेटिंग फॉर युअर रिस्पॉन्स. जरा विचार करायला शिका, डिस्टन्स इक्वल टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट यायला पाहिजे. केव्हा होईल? व्हेन विल इट बी पॉसिबल. Take your time and then reply. अरे द क्वेश्चन इज डिस्टेंस इक्वल टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट केव्हा येईल, डिस्टेंस इक्वल टू डिस्प्लेसमेंट केव्हा येईल,